Hello, ladies and gents, welcome back. I've been sick, so I haven't done a preview about this Madrid clay court tournament, one of the nine masters. So I'm just gonna go into the quarterfinals. I'm gonna jump in late in this tournament. If I have time, I will talk about the tournament so far, but I'm gonna dig in and just start with the quarterfinals. The first quarterfinals that I'm gonna talk about is Dominic Thiem against Jon Isner, and Thiem have met three times before. It's 2-1 in favor for Dominic Thiem. Thiem who beat Giron and de Minaur yesterday is here. He's been away from tennis for 2 months. He's starting to get warm. He's starting to hit those backhands, and he's solid from both his wings, Dominic Thiem. So he actually, to be honest, so far, of all the eight candidates here, he's the one that he and Zverev are probably the only ones that can take out Rafael Nadal so far, in my opinion. But Thiem has still a little bit to achieve, to go up in level, to be the Dominic Thiem we have seen in the clay court tournaments before. He still have something to work on. He doesn't return so well that he has done previously, but he has his kick serve, he has his firepower that can hit through, and he needs to return better if he want to take out Jon Isner, because Isner has defeated Kecmanovic, RBA, and Rublev in his previous round, and the match between him and RBA and the match against Rublev went to a deciding tiebreak set. And if you average 30 aces in this tournament, it's hard to get through Jon Isner. So we all know that he's all about serve. He's a serve boot, but he's a clutch tiebreak player. He's a master of these mini breaks in tiebreaks. He takes the opportunity. So you have to really take him. You have to put your teeth into his serve. If you can do that, you are doomed to lose against Jon Isner. So it's simple as that, because this fast hard court clay court, it's like a hard court tournament, because Isner will get re he gets rewarded for his serve here. So that's why he has average 30 aces in every of his matches, if I'm not mistaken. I think he has done 89 aces or 90. But anyway, so Thiem really has to return good in his match. If he get one break, he will definitely win the match, because Isner, he's not a great clay court player. He's not a great baseliner. He has a great forehand, but otherwise he's vulnerable, and Thiem can move him around and make him out of control. So if Thiem returns good, he will win this match. Otherwise, it can be either way. It can go to three tiebreaks. But we all know that Thiem is also a great tiebreak player. So I give my edge to Thiem due to his level, but I will not be surprised if Isner beats him. Even if he beats him in two sets, I will not be surprised. Right. The next match is between Rafael Nadal and Sasha Zverev. They have met 7 times. Nadal won the first five, and Zverev have won the two last matches. It was at Paris Indoors and the ATP Finals. His victories was at hard court indoor, where Rafa is vulnerable, but Rafa has looked solid. He took care of the birthday boy Alcaraz. He gave him a breadstick. He really didn't have any trouble against Poporin. It was exciting for like two or three games. Nadal did this average play like he does in the first rounds. Not average, but he's too heavy. He's too great. He's too solid. He's too consistent. He's too determined. He doesn't give you anything for free, Nadal. We have talked about this many times in the videos. I will not go on and talk more about Nadal on clay. It's like facing a wall. It's like facing a brick. It's like facing the Chinese wall. You can't. You have to have firepower to hit through him. Otherwise, Nadal will. He moves like a gazelle on court. He will fish up every point. He will penetrate those hard ground strokes from both wings, and we all know his backhand, his forehand, his serve. He's complete player, and he will. If Sasha is gonna take him out on clay, it's on this surface and it's on this at this tournament. We have seen Nadal before. He has won this tournament 5 times. He has lost 4 finals, 2 against Novak, 1 against Murray, and then it was another, I forgot which he which it was, and Federer, of course. Those are the matches that he has lost. So he has been 9 finals, won 5 of them. So he is not unbeatable here. All right, to the bottom half of the draw, we have Bublik against Casper Ruud. Casper Ruud is up 1-0. They have met one time. Bublik have really impressed me, this light version of Nick Kyrgios. They have similar playing style. They have even played with the same racket, I think. I think Kyrgios is his idol. If you look at his how he conducts himself on court, but he's not into this bad temper decisions. He stays cool, but he likes to trick. He likes to play artistic tennis. He has a great serve, great backhand, great forehand. And he moves well on court. He has impressed me after his victories against Fuskovic and Shapovalov and Karatsev. That is not bad. That's not a bad achievement. It's great. So, Bublik against Casper Ruud, the Norwegian dude, who has beaten him once. He defeated Aliassime in the first round, Nishioka, and Tsitsipas yesterday. All of his victories come in straight sets. Impressive, but I know, maybe you know also, many of the tennis fans out there knows that he's a decent clay court player. The match against Tsitsipas in advance, of course, the match was was in Tsitsipas' favor due to his level and how he had played the last 3 weeks. So I was not surprised, actually, but I thought that Ruud can upset him, maybe take a set, make it the deciding set a little bit exciting, but it was him on court only. Tsitsipas tried, he looked a little bit rusty, but Ruud played great. He is a grinder, so it was hard for Tsitsipas to hit through him. And Tsitsipas touch and feeling when he approached the net wasn't as accurate as always. He didn't serve great, he didn't return great, so it was not a tough battle for Casper Ruud, because he played decent, solid tennis, and he's a huge baseliner. He slides great on court, he moves, he has great shot selections, he has a great tennis mind, and yesterday the better player won. It's small margins in tennis. All right, the last quarterfinal between Berrettini and Garin. Berrettini have impressed me, but he has met Fognini, who we all know that when he wakes up on the right side, he's a terrible opponent to face, but otherwise he's an average player. And Delbonis tried, he couldn't. He's a decent clay court player, but the Berrettini's firepower, especially from his first serve and forehand, was just too much for the Argentinian tall lefty with great hands. He plays with great touch tennis, and Berrettini, on the other hand, he moves great on court. He likes to go around and hit his forehand from his backhand side, so he has looked very good in this tournament. But if we'll take on and win against Garin, that's another task. They have met once, and what was in the Munich final in 2019, where Garin won. So has beaten Verdasco in the first round, and then he beat Köpfer, and then he took out Medvedev, who his game style, his flat shots doesn't work so much on clay. He doesn't get rewarded, and its game is easier to read. It's easier to catch up his ball at clay. And like my dear friend Inter Interi said in his preview, he thought that his run would end with Garin or the round before, and it did. I was on the same path there when we talked on the phone. So shout out to Inter Interi for a great preview of the quarterfinals. Truly the best YouTuber I've witnessed at YouTube when it comes to tennis. My dear friend, keep on, keep moving, keep delivering those videos to us tennis lovers. So I think that the match between Bublik and Ruud, I think that Ruud will take this one, and I think that Berrettini will win against Garin. That's my prediction. And Nadal will take his match against Zverev difficult. Nadal faces his first test, but we know that Nadal and tennis, he has the highest low level. He plays high percentage tennis. And he's a consistent clay court machine. If Zverev really wants to win, he has to hit bomb serves. He doesn't. His second serve will have to work. He had to return great. He's a okay returner. He will have to hold his head high and cold in the clutch moments. Then he have a chance to take Rafa. But I give Rafa 65% to get through this match. So I have a final semifinal between Thiem and Nadal, and between Berrettini and Casper Ruud. That's my prediction and preview of the upcoming quarterfinals at Madrid. Thanks for watching this video. Take care and bye bye.